12 News' Jason Newton is here with how that could help and hurt the state.
Itoy economists agree that government workers get a pretty good deal when it comes to benefits and retirement, but they say the economy is forcing them to feel some of the pain that the private sector has been feeling for some time.
That was one perk that public sector employees had.
BizTimes editor Steve Jagler says public employee benefits have long outpaced that of the private sector.
The fiscal reality that the state finds itself in right now, I think, is going to necessitate that public sector employees are going to have to pay more of their retirements and plans and their health care benefits.
Now the governor-elect says a shared sacrifice, private to public, must be made to help balance the state budget. No group knows that better than Milwaukee teachers. They recently signed off on a pay freeze and a first partial payment of their health insurance premiums.
Our focus was on teaching and learning and improving work in the classroom. So with the extra work as well as the concessions, it was difficult.
Marquette professor Paul Secunda agrees that it's a necessary evil, one he says could dilute the state's talent pool, especially if public unions lose power under Walker.
It has to compete for good candidates with the private sector, and historically speaking, states that have not had public sector unions have public employees who make a lot less compensation.
He also says when you consider the cost of benefits, you also need to consider how much people make. He says lower wages and paying more benefits would not be attractive to prospective workers.